Well, the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services has been tracking disparities in health care across the country. And as WXXI's Sasha-Ann Simons has learned, local health professionals are trying to fill in some of the gaps. Sasha?
That's right, Helen. According to the Agency for Healthcare Research and Quality, access and disparities in access to healthcare are the primary reasons the U.S. health system falls behind other countries. In other words, too many people don't have full access to essential health services. I spent some time over the last few weeks meeting health professionals in Rochester trying to break that barrier for people who live in the city. Here's more.
In Rochester's refugee community, the lack of English language skills becomes even more prevalent when it comes to health issues.
Not bad. About 136 over 90. Are you taking your medication?
Sarah Miner is a community health nurse who has been doing home care for the last 6 years. About 4 years ago, she connected with Refugees Helping Refugees, an agency supporting people who've had to leave their home country by putting people who have been through the same experiences at the front line. Miner began working with the group, offering the medical expertise they couldn't. She recalls a past home visit with an elderly woman from Somalia.
She has this bag with medications in it, but she told us she doesn't know what they are.
Chronic illness is often a new concept for refugees.
An acute illness, you take a medication, you take it, the illness ends. They understand that. But this idea that you have an illness that you have to take medications, perhaps for the rest of your life, that's very new to them.
According to the latest National Healthcare Disparities Report, published by the Health Department in 2015, despite improvements, disparities in access to healthcare persist, especially among people in poor households, Hispanic people, and African Americans.
Come on, start playing.
69-year-old Sarah Laza admits her English is not the best, but she has a good understanding of the medication that's been prescribed for her to take every day.
I need my medicine. I don't play with my medicine.
The Puerto Rican woman suffered a cardiac arrest 6 years ago, and there were two heart attacks in the years before that.
I have 5 for the blood pressure, 2 for my heart, my insulin.
Laza is organizing next week's set of pills in a package she gets from Saratoga Pharmacy in downtown Rochester and credits the pharmacy's easy-to-use packaging system and multilingual staff for helping to maintain her health.
Sometimes the doctor changed my medicine and I don't know how to use it. They explain, they call me, and they say this, like that. In Spanish.
Saratoga Pharmacy has stood at Lyle and Saratoga Avenues for decades. But now, since a takeover in 2015 by its third owner, the local pharmacy is becoming a staple in the community.
All right, let me check for you.
We wanted somebody here who speaks the native language. So I started like hiring people who speaks their own language. We have like all like multicultural employees here, like Nepali. We have Somali. We have Burmese.
And in addition to Spanish-speaking staff helping customers like Laza, pharmacists, technicians, and clerks also speak Korean, Greek, and Hindi. CEO Usha Ramadagu says she immediately saw the challenges for people living in the city. Language was one. Access to reliable, cost-effective transportation was another, which drove Ramadagu to offer free medication delivery nearly round the clock.
But the third one is like compliance. 58% of the population, they do the errors in taking the medication. And that end up in chronic conditions.
Through the use of medication therapy management, Saratoga Pharmacy acts as the ultimate go-between for doctors and their patients. Pharmacists counsel people about their medications and coordinate with other pharmacies to ease the customer's burden. The effort, Ramadagu says, also helps reduce hospital readmissions. The effects of a sudden hip replacement surgery prompted Diane Moultrie to call Saratoga Pharmacy last year. Having limited ability to walk, Moultrie relies heavily on their delivery service.
Being as how I live alone and I don't have any family in Rochester, there was nobody to go get my medicine for me.
The customized pill packaging, marking daily and time of day dosages, has helped Moultrie stay on top of her health.
You know, as you get older, it's like your memory doesn't work the way it used to.
Yeah, and we were actually just talking.
At a time when new leadership takes over in Washington, the future of healthcare in America is unknown. Medicare and the Affordable Care Act could undergo major changes or be replaced entirely. Miner says she's frightened by the possibilities, but remains hopeful for the immigrants in her care.
We have to have an efficient and safe delivery of health care for all people in this country.
Sasha-Ann Simons, WXXI News.